Shalom Chaverim, this is Rabbi Shapira, Rega Beivrit, special outdoor edition from Sri Lanka. This week we are in Parashat Toldot, and I'm actually here in the cemetery, and I want you to notice right next to me, I found two Jewish graves actually. One of them of somebody named Levi, and another one, an unidentified one. And I was thinking about this Torah portion this week in Parashat Toldot. You see, when we talked to the locals here, the locals told us something interesting. They told us that even there are people who had headstones, people who had headstones here that had Hebrew on them, and they removed them. They removed those headstones with the Hebrew on them in order to not be identified as Jewish people. What is the source of all of this? In the Torah this week, we read this word, Vayitrotzetzu Abanim Bekirbeah. The two children, Yaakov and Esav, were, the word there, itrotzetzu, come from the word ratz. Ratz meaning people to run. They run into each other and they clashed against each other in the water womb. There was a feud between Esav and Yaakov in the womb. Who is Esav? Interestingly enough, Esav in Hebrew, equivalent to the word Shalom. The most wicked Jew in the world called by the name of Shalom. Why is it? Esav is a representation of Christianity. Yaakov, whose name was changed to Israel, is a representation of the Jewish people. There is an historical feud that started even before Christianity between the descendants of Yaakov and the son of Esav, Edom, who is today a mirror of Christianity. Today, I want to tell you that even here in this island of Sri Lanka, even in the island of Sri Lanka here, we had Jewish people, Bnei Anusim, who are had the chance to come here to escape Catholicism and were found, persecuted, murdered here in this island. Why is it important? Because in the Torah portion this week, we read that after the feud between Yaakov and Esav, it was actually Esav who ran to Yaakov to reconcile with Yaakov. Okay? And he came. They said, "V'kem v'nashkeu." He kissed him. The word "neshika" in Hebrew is related to the word "neshicha," bite and a kiss. Which one are we going to choose today? As Esav, the follower of Yeshua, to kiss the Jewish people, or to bite the Jewish people? Are we going to harm them, or are we going to come and reconcile with them? We have a job today of doing an historic reconciliation that is overdue for 2,000 years, and stop the running and fighting with Judaism and embrace and reconcile Esav back to Yaakov. This is our great mandate in these last days. I hope you enjoyed this Rega Beivrit. God bless you.